Next up, it is time for our 8 finalists to demonstrate their public speaking abilities. The self-expression category evaluates participants' speaking ability, clarity of response, and grace under pressure. Just as a reminder, this category comprises 15% of their overall score. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back our 8 finalists in self-expression.
Each finalist will step forward and select a random question to which they will respond. Ladies, are you ready? Okay, great. We'll start with number 1, Mississippi, Laura Fung. Her question. 10 states have legalized the recreational use of marijuana. Do you agree with this change in policy?
In life, it's so important to really value the relationships that we have with each other and to treat other people with respect. So as long as our decisions, our personal decisions, don't have a negative impact on the other people around in our life, we should be allowed to make the decisions that we think is best for ourselves. This is the only way that we can be our best selves. So ultimately, if recreational use of marijuana won't hinder the safety of those around those who choose to use marijuana, then I believe that it should be legalized. Lori Fung, Mississippi.
Next, we have finalist number 2 from Oklahoma, Evelyn Smith. Evelyn's question, school and workplace shootings continue to happen on a regular basis. How do you propose this be addressed?
Many of my friends and I are passionate about these issues because we are tired of seeing our neighbors, our friends, people across the country, we are tired of seeing them die. I believe the way that we approach this is by empowerment, by supporting programs like this, where I am surrounded by 42 other girls and 7 other girls here, where we share our strengths. Now that, I believe, is the way that we are going to change the nation and our future and prevent these things from happening. Evelyn Smith, Oklahoma.
Finalist number 3, Louisiana, Sarah Catherine McCallum. Her question for Sarah is, there are a record number of women serving in Congress, but we still only make up 24% of its members. How can we encourage more women to run for office?
The way that we encourage more women to run for office is simple. It's 2 reasons. We ensure that they will be heard and taken seriously, and we also ensure their safety. Women are often fearful to go into politics because they're afraid of being either sexually harassed or not taken seriously by their male counterparts while on the floor. This is how we solve this problem. Sarah Catherine McCallum, Louisiana.
Finalist number 4 from Illinois is Dora Guo. and Dora's question. Many point to recent extreme weather events as an example of climate change. Do you agree?
Science does not lie. There have been enough signs across the country and across the globe to prove that climate change is real. Instead of questioning the validity of what we see around us, we need to start to encourage our congressmen to formulate ideas on how to address this situation before it's too late. Dora Gore, Illinois.
As we've reached our halfway point, we too shall make a switcheroo. Our fifth finalist, from Utah, Sarah Son. Sarah's question. What is the most important trait people need in order to be successful? Do you have it?
The most important trait is perspective. So many times it's easy to get caught up into the competition, the awards, and the accolades, but when what really matters to be successful are the relationships that we forge along the way. Nobody who's accomplished anything has ever done so without a tribe of people supporting them. And when we're able to be grateful for this, then anything can be a success. I'm grateful for the people who have lifted me up to this point, and I do believe that they've helped me gain the perspective to always count my blessings instead of focusing on the things that don't truly matter. Sarah Son, Utah.
Our sixth finalist, North Carolina, Gracie Stanek. Gracie's question, do you think your generation is different from those who came before you?
Our generation is different. There is no denying that. However, our uniqueness from those who came before us is a great thing. It is what allows us to be leaders and world changers. It is this difference from our predecessors that we are able to make change in the world, and we must embrace it. Gracie Stanek, North Carolina.
Finalist number 7 from Ohio, Olivia Fossen. And Olivia's question. Incidents of online bullying have become common as social media usage has grown. How would you address this issue?
It is so easy when you're sitting behind a screen to not realize that those people you're talking to are real people and have feelings. My generation has grown accustomed to growing up in a social media age, and sometimes we take advantage of this. This can be perfected by enforcing stricter regulations for what you post and also teaching children in school to respect each other and teaching them that everyone has feelings regardless if you see them in person or behind a screen. Olivia Fossen, Ohio.
And finalist 8 from Hawaii, Eden Chun. Of course, you have a choice. And her question, is life fair?
Unfortunately, I don't think it is. But that's why we have to look for the fair parts of life or the parts that make us happy. We need to redefine success so that it isn't always unattainable, and we aren't always looking for this mindset of achieving, and gaining, when what we should be doing is reflecting inside and being satisfied with what we have around us. Eden Chun, Hawaii.